Welcome to this brief guide on how to create images with Microsoft Image Creator. There are plenty of popular tools to help you create AI art, such as Midjourney and Stable Diffusion, but these generally require a paid license to take full advantage of. So today, I'm going to show you how you can create AI-generated art for free with the Microsoft Image Creator. To access it, simply open your preferred web browser and head to bing.com/create. This will bring you directly over to the Microsoft Image Creator, and we'll see at the top here that it is powered by the DALL-E engine. Currently, the version in use is DALL-E 3. And you'll be able to see over on the side here that I'm currently signed in to my Microsoft account. This is important, and you want to be signed in to a Microsoft account, and the reason for this is that you are allocated credits, and these credits can be utilized to create images. If you run out of credits, you can still create images, but it will generally take longer in order to do so. There's other advantages to being signed into your account, and that is because all the creations that you make are saved directly to your account, and so you can access them later on. I'll show this off later in this video. And now in order to create an image, we simply need to enter in a prompt. I've got one saved in my clipboard here, and so I'm going to try and generate a movie poster in the style of Disney that says Disney's WALL-E 3 with a picture of a robot on top of a pile of electronic trash. And then I simply click on the Create button and let the image creator get to work. Now I'll leave this happening in real time so you can see how long these images usually take to be generated when you have credits available. And there you can see I now have four images that all match my prompt pretty accurately. Clicking on any of them, I'll be able to see a larger sized preview, and I can use the arrow keys on either the left or right to cycle through the four images that I have generated. Now you'll also notice over on the right hand side, I have a copy of the prompt that I utilized, but I also have quick buttons so I can easily share this particular image as a link. I can also save it to any collections I have in Microsoft Edge. I can even download it, or I can utilize the customize button to head over to Microsoft Designer, which I'll show later on in this video as well. Now I mentioned previously that all of your creations are saved, and you can access all of those recent creations in the film strip over here on the right hand side. Selecting any of those will show you a larger preview of those particular four images. These ones here I actually created last night using the image creation feature that's also built in to the Microsoft Bing mobile app. Now heading back to my WALL-E images, I mentioned that you can have this great integration with Microsoft Designer. So in order to utilize that, we simply select this Customize button, and this will bring us over in a brand new tab straight to Microsoft Designer. And our context is going to come along with us. So the image I had selected has automatically been added to my design prompt, and I have a text box where I can also put in some details around what type of creation I'd like to make. If I don't want to create one, I can utilize one of the default options over here and simply select that option and click on Customize Design to begin customizing it further. If you'd like a deeper dive into Microsoft Designer, check out the video on my channel. I'll have it linked in the description below. And that is how you generate AI art using the Microsoft Image Creator for free. Now it's your turn to get creative with your prompting and try it out for yourself. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.